In this final segment for the first ray tracing lecture, we are going to consider optimizations and acceleration. Testing each object for each ray is slow. This is one of the causes why ray tracing has historically been slow. One can therefore consider using fewer rays by adaptively sampling which pixels to shoot a ray for by having adaptive depth controls. One could also consider generalized rays, where you shoot multiple rays at a time, things like beam tracing, cone tracing, pencil tracing, and so on. Finally, one can consider faster intersections, where one optimizes a ray object intersection, so ray triangle intersections are very optimized, or, and this is where most of the acceleration work falls, one can have fewer intersections. We come to an rich area of ray tracing known as acceleration structures, where given a ray, you want to ensure that you test as few objects as possible, ideally only the object the ray will hit. That's not possible in practice, but we can often consider the number of intersections to be logarithmic in the total size of the number of objects. So first, we consider bounding boxes, possibly hierarchically, so you could have a bounding box for the whole scene, the bounding box for your room, a bounding box for the various triangles in your room. If the ray doesn't intersect the entire bounding box, and remember there are very efficient ray box intersection tests, then one needs to check the individual objects within the bounding box. One can also consider spatial hierarchies that organize these bounding boxes, things like octrees, KD trees, BSP trees. BSP stands for binary space partitioning. Octree takes 3D space, cuts it along the center for each axis of a cube to break it into 8 octants. Another acceleration structure is a grid, and so this could be a regular grid or a hierarchical grid. As far as we're concerned, we're going to consider just a regular grid. I trace my ray through the grid. So what I do is I first go to the first grid cell, and I see there's no intersection. Also note that the traversal through the grid might seem irregular, but in fact there are regular intersection points along either of the two axes here, or three axes in 3D. And so you can very simply and incrementally compute the next intersection point in the next cell. So I go to the next cell, and each cell has a pointer to all of the objects that intersect that cell. The next cell after that, the next cell after that. And now we can see that I have an intersection that I need to test. So I need to test my ray against this object, but it doesn't intersect. So I go to the next point. And if I implement something like mailboxing, I know I've already tested against this object, so I don't need to test again. Come down here. Again, I need to test against this object. No intersection. Go forward. And finally, I hit the object that I'm actually intersecting. One of the interesting things to note is that the two objects on the side, so this object and this object, were never tested against. There was no need to actually even test them for intersection. And so large part of the space that is not in the traversal part actually need never be tested for a ray surface intersection. So regular grids are the simplest acceleration structure. So for example, a 5x5x5 grid. For each grid cell, you store all the overlapping triangles. You march the ray along the grid. You need to be careful in doing this efficiently. And you test against each triangle in the grid cell. There are, of course, more complicated spatial data structures like KD trees, octrees, BSP trees, or you can use hierarchical bounding boxes.